Having introduced the singular homology, verified a number of its interesting properties, and proved that computed the homology of a single point, and proved that the homology, the singular homology, is the direct sum of the singular homology of its path components, etc. Yet, at this stage, we still do not have a powerful tool to compute the homology. So now we shall discuss one of the most important concepts, namely excision, which will yield a powerful tool. You can say this is called Mayer-Vittrie's principle. In real terms, this will give you a long homology exact sequence. Okay, and that will help a little more, much more than whatever we have done so far. So let us start with something. Namely, start with any two subspaces of a topological space X. Okay, and denote the inclusion maps by eta I. They will induce inclusion maps again from S of xi to S of x, singular chains. Okay, now consider the chain map from the direct sum to Sx, S dot of x, namely A1, A2. So the direct sum eta 1 comma minus eta 2 defined on S dot x1 direct sum S dot x2, taking A1 comma A2 to A1 minus A2. Take this map. This will be clearly a chain map. The linear combination of chain maps is a chain map, and the inclusion maps are chain maps. Okay, what is the kernel of this map? Remember, S dot x, S dot x1, S dot x2, they are all free abelian groups. So the direct sum is a free abelian group. Okay. So, an element is zero means all the coefficients of each singular simplex is zero. That is the meaning of, that is the only way, right? So kernel means what now? If A1 and A2 are chains in S1 of X and S2 of X, then corresponding coefficients of the singular chains must be identical for A1 and A2. That is the meaning of A1 minus A2 is zero. Okay. This just means that A1 is identically equal to A2 in Sx. But they are inside, one is inside X1, another inside X2. Okay. Therefore, A1 equal to A2 must be inside S of X1 intersection X2. So you can easily check that S of S dot of X1 intersection X2 is actually the kernel, the entire kernel. Now, what is the image of this one? That is easy to check. It is just like one element from here, one element from here. Whether you take the sum or difference, same thing, sum of elements here. Okay. So that will be a submodule here. Right? And that submodule is usually written as the sum, just without the direct sum, without the direct sum notation, ordinary sum. So S dot of x1 plus S dot of x2. So this is the image. Okay, therefore we have a short exact sequence S of x1 intersection x2, the direct sum and the ordinary sum to zero. This is the image, so this is exact because I can put zero here. That is the kernel of this map. Namely, this map is a1 comma a2 going to a1 minus a2. Okay, so you know exactly what map is, though I have not written here. So this will then give a exact sequence of long exact sequence of homology modules from which we hope, and of course we have experienced this, namely there will be information on H star of the central chain complex here, sorry, H star of the sum here in terms of H star of the direct sum means A star of direct sum is direct sum of itself. So this we know, if you know A star of x1 and A star of x2, and something we know about A star of the intersection. The two space subspaces, we should know what is happening there. We should know what is happening in the intersection. Then we may be able to say something about the union. So this theme was there, exactly the same theme in Venkampan's theorem about fundamental group. Okay, so this principle is known here, goes under the name Mayer-Vitteres, two Austrian mathematicians of early last century. So the question is, can we replace S star of SX1 plus SX2 with S star of X? Why we hope to do that? Because topologically X1 and X2 is the whole of X. That is the starting point. But can we do this algebra S star of S1, X2, replace it by this one? Are they equal? This is some kind of a sub of this one, though it is not a sub. So only the chain complex is a sub of the corresponding S of X. Okay, so is there some kind of isomorphism? So this is the question. Okay, we shall now proceed towards some affirmative answers to this question. The first technical part for the first thing was the, we are making a lemma here, the positive answer, finally, beautiful answer came by Mayer-Vitteres sequence. That is our aim. Okay, so this is algebraic preliminary for that. How to deal with this one? Namely, when can we replace this by H star of X itself? So as usual, take X equal to A union B. I have changed the notation here instead of X1 and X2 deliberately because this is applicable in a larger context. Then the following statements are equivalent. The sum of S of A and S of B to S of X induces isomorphism in homology. So this is a very clear statement, namely, the inclusion-induced homomorphism, this is inclusion-induced homomorphism, must be itself isomorphism. That is what is demanded in this one. Okay, the second thing is another condition, SA plus SB go modulo SB on both sides, that is induced an isomorphism on the homology. Pass to the homology, then it's a, these are chain complexes, these are chain maps. When you pass the homology, it must be an isomorphism. The third condition is symmetric in A and B after all. SA SB, instead of Go modulo SB on both sides, Go modulo SA. So these two are obviously just symmetric condition, because A and B, there are no other conditions here. X is A union B, that's all. The fourth condition is slightly different now. Just take SA and S of A intersection B to SX modulo SB. Okay, so you are going down SB. SB is not here, it's SA. So I have to take S of A intersection B here. There's a map here, homomorphism at the chain complex level. This inducing isomorphism in homology is what we want. The fifth one is similar. Now, instead of SA, I took SB, SB to S of A intersection B to SX by SA. So this is just usual kind of, what you can term as Noether's isomorphism theorem, first isomorphism, second isomorphism, and so on. It is of that nature. So let us quickly go through this one. Equivalence of A and B is a consequence of five lemma. See, we have opportunity to use this five lemmas, which we have introduced just a couple of days back. SA plus SB to SX, there is a Neclosian map. This is the quotient of SA plus SB by SB. And that is the kernel. So this is an exact sequence. SA plus SB, when you quotient out of SB, you can quotient out the same thing by SB on this side also. That will give you the same map, inclusion map, gives rise to this map. You can call this inclusion. Okay, so this is inclusion induced map. This is the restriction map, only to SB, and this identity map here. The identity map, okay, gives an isomorphism. Therefore, this is an isomorphism if and only if this is an isomorphism. The five lemma says that if this is actually much simpler than five lemma, because both these two are zeros here. Okay. So this is an isomorphism and this is an isomorphism. But if this is an isomorphism and this is identity isomorphism, it's clearly this isomorphism is obvious. Yeah. So once you have this, okay, when you go to homology level, this is an isomorphism would imply this is an isomorphism, because now you have to use five lemma when you take the ladder. So HI to HI minus 1 to HI minus 1 to HI minus 1. So alternatively, you will get this and these are isomorphisms. Again, they will repeat here. So the middle one will be isomorphism. So that is the five lemma which you have to apply to the long exact sequence above and below. Okay. B and D, let us look at B and D, S of A plus S of B, modulo SB, SB. I have taken modulo SB here, and I am taking modulo S intersection B. So this is precisely like the isomorphism theorem. Okay. B and D follow from the commutative diagram below, in which the horizontal arrow is the isomorphism theorem given by Noether isomorphism theorem. SA to SA intersection B to SA plus SB by SB. This is Noether isomorphism theorem. You say this is an isomorphism if and only if this is an isomorphism. So B implies D. Okay, this is B, this is D. Okay. Interchanging A and B, you will get C implies E. A and B are equivalent, okay, by the five lemma and the long exact sequences. B and D are equivalent because of the Noether isomorphism theorem. Interchanging A and B, what do you get? C and E are equivalent. All right. So once you have B is there, just interchange A and B, roll A and B. A will give you C also. A and C are equivalent. C and E are equivalent. So all the five statements are equivalent. Equivalent to each other. Okay. So now we shall make a definition. Take X a topological space and A and B be any two subspaces. Okay. Just for the sake of definiteness, you can say X is A union B, which is not necessary if you want to just work with A union B. Let X be there, but we want to work with A union B. So I have cut down X itself is A union B, which is the same thing as saying, this is just a set theory thing, X minus B is equal to A minus A intersection B. Okay, we then say the inclusion map A to A comma A intersection B to XB is an excision map. So I could have directly said this one, namely this is A1, A2 to Xn by the difference X minus B here, set theoretic difference, is equal to the difference here, and they are inclusion maps. So such a thing is excision map. So this is purely set theoretic condition. Okay. In the relative thing, whatever extra space comes must be the same in both the cases. And this whole thing is an inclusion map. A pair AB of topological subspaces of X is called excessive couple. So this definition is something different. Okay. This is not a trivial thing. For singular homology, so excessive couple for singular homology, okay? Excessive couple for some other homology or something else, there may be different excessive couples. Excessive couple for singular homology, so we are defining like this. If the inclusion map S of A plus S of B to S of A union B at the singular chain complex level, this must induce an isomorphism in homology. So that is the first condition of this lemma. Right? S of A plus B to S of X, X is A union B. Okay. Which is the same thing as or any of these five conditions. So we are taking conveniently the first condition. And that is what our aim was after all. Okay, so we take that condition and make it into a definition. So where were we? If this inclusion map is an isomorphism in homology, or if any one of the other four equivalent conditions of the lemma is satisfied. Condition D of this lemma immediately gives us, you can write it as a theorem, inclusion map A intersection B to A union B, B, this is always an excision map. This is an excessive couple. Okay. So the inclusion map of an excessive couple AB. AB is an excessive couple means what? H star of SA plus SB to H star of AB is an isomorphism. So that is the hypothesis. If that is the case, okay, I can write it as inducing isomorphism. This is if and only if this is inducing isomorphism, okay, then H star of A intersection B, H star of A union B, this is an isomorphism. That is condition D here. Let us look at this one. A plus B modulo H star of A is relatively A union B modulo A to, sorry, this is C, this D is A intersection B to XP. Okay. Yeah. So A intersection B to X, which is A union B to B. Okay. So this is just a restatement of lemma, the above lemma here, and the definition. So you should remember that if I give this condition, then this is true. If I give this condition, that is true. That's all you have to do. Note that a pair AB is excessive or not. The inclusion map is always an excision map. An excessive couple, there must be some homology condition. Okay. So this excision map is just to tell you that A union B, the biggest thing, minus B, is A minus A intersection B. Okay. So instead of saying all that, you take a pair of topological spaces and say this is an excision map, that's all. So excision theorem is precisely due to Meritorious. The present form is due to Eilenberg and Strindrod. Okay. So between Meritorious sequence invention of this and proper modern formulation by Eilenberg Schirper, it took almost 20-25 years. Okay. So Meritorious did not prove it in this way. If X is the union of X1 and X2 in such a way that if you just take interior of X1 and interior of X2, that must cover the whole of X, then X1, X2 is an excessive couple for singular homology. So this is a statement, which just means now that I can replace S of X1 plus S of X2 by S of X itself. Replacing means what? Passing to the homology, after passing to homology. So this condition looks strange, but this, suppose X1 and X2 are open subsets, then interior of X1 is X1 itself, interior of X2 is X2 itself. Okay, this is the easiest way how the excision theorem can be applied. Whenever two subsets are there which are open and they cover the whole space X, then you are in good shape. Then you can compute the homology of the whole space in some sense by knowing the homology of X1, homology of X2, and the homology of the intersection. How you can do that is the long homology Eilenberg sequence. So that part, putting it into a long homology Eilenberg sequence, is Eilenberg-Strindrod's contribution. Okay, the principle and the details of this theorem, for example, like this, were there in work of Mayer and Meritorious. All right. We shall postpone the proof of this theorem, just like we have postponed the proof of homotopy axiom, homotopy invariance of the homology. Okay. For the present, we shall only make a remark. What kind of proof is there? Okay. Given a singular n simplex sigma, which may not be inside X1 or may not be inside X2. Okay. So it's in the union of X1 and X2. Assume for the time being that X1 and X2 are themselves open. Okay. Then the typical thing to do, just like in all analysis work, you have to cut down the simplex into finer pieces, such that each part is inside x1 or x2. So one subdivides delta n in such a way that the image of each subsimplex of this subdivision is contained inside x1 or x2. One thinks of original singular simplex sigma as an appropriate sum of these little pieces. It's just like integration theory. If you have an interval of definition, you can cut it down into two intervals. Integral on the entire thing is same thing as integral over the first part and the integral over second part. The similar things are there for area and all that. All that you need is that integration should not overlap. Then you have, so this is the homology, this is the motivation, and this is how all this homology was developed. Through motivation and guidance from what happens in the integration theory, in analysis. Okay, you cut it down into little pieces. Strictly speaking though, they are different chains, and most of the effort is to show that they represent the same element in homology groups. So somehow you have to show that there is no integration, nothing. So we have a different kind of definitions, and we have to show that in homology they represent the same element. In analysis, it is the same thing as the integration is the same. Of course, all this thing has to be done in a canonical fashion. Not exactly depending upon the actual nature of x1 and x2. Once you have done the whole thing, it should be true for when you are writing some other y1 union y2 also, where y1 and y2 are open subsets and so on. Okay, now let us stop there first. For more explanations, etc., for actual proof, we have to wait. But now let me give an example. Here's a few examples of Chebyshev couples. Okay, which occur in practice. The first one is, take the disk Dn, closed disk or open disk, let's take open disk Dn, okay, Rn minus 0. That is also an open set. The union is the whole of Rn. Right? I want to say this is an excessive couple because Dn is open subset and Rn minus 0 is also an open subset. Over. But now the conclusion is that dn minus 0, which is the intersection of dn and rn minus 0, right, to rn minus 0, this inclusion map induces isomorphisms in the singular homology groups. And this is one of the very useful thing. Okay, this is starting point of our discussion in manifold theory and so on. We will see that. Okay, the second one, take the sphere Sn, let N and S denote the north pole and south pole. Okay, I am just looking at the north pole now. And let U bar denote the closed upper hemisphere, okay. Then Sn minus N, Sn minus 1 is what? The top point, namely the north pole is deleted, that's all. And U bar, this is an excessive couple, and hence the inclusion induced map should be an isomorphism in the homology. What is that? U bar minus N, which is what you get when you take Sn minus N intersection U bar. So Sn modulo Sn minus singleton N, so everything is here in that one except the one point here. This is the same thing as U bar minus N. I have deliberately taken U bar here. U bar is not an open set, but interior of U bar and Sn minus n, they are open subsets and they cover the whole thing. That's enough. So u bar is not open here yet. See, here also I told you dn could have been a closed disk also. Okay, the interior of dn and rn minus 0, they are open and then they cover it. So that's enough. So that was this kind of statement here in this era. Interior of x1 and interior of x2, they cover the whole space. Okay, so these two things we will use again, that they are excessive couples, so there is an isomorphism like this in the homology. All right. For more examples, we will have to wait. So today we will stop here. Thank you.